Welcome back to my channel. Friends, this is Viper16L IC. It is used in buck converter, boost converter, flyback converters, isolated or non-isolated. It is switching IC. It has built-in MOSFET. When we apply power, how this IC takes start? This is a question from my viewer. If you have time, how does 16-pin Viper16L provides initial starting voltage? I have looked the data sheet, but I don't fully understand it. Thank you. Viper 16 is fixed frequency switching IC. It has two models. If the last number L, 16L, that means that is 60 kilohertz. If 16H, that is 115 kHz. It is available in DIP 7 dual inline package or SMD 16 pin. Either it is 16 pin or 7 pin, the pins are same. First we will see pin out. If we look here, pin 1, 2, ground. In 7 pin, pin 1 is ground. 3 and 4 number pin not connected. In 16 pin IC, not connected, not available. Then VDD pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pin number 5 in 16 pin, that is VDD, and here is pin number 2 VDD. We can see here two pins are ground, then VDD, and here is ground, then VDD. Then here limit pin, current limit, and here is current limit. Feedback, feedback. Here pin number 8 is compensation, and if you look here, pin number 5 is compensation. Then 9, 10, 11, 12. These all pins are not connected. Pin number 6 here, not available. Then 13, 14, 15 and 16. 4 pins are drain pin. Here 7 and 8 number pins are drain pin. Pin function is same. Let's see its internal structure. Ground pin is connected to ground, and here is current sense resistor, then built-in MOSFET, then here is drain pin. Drain drives the primary winding of the transformer. Primary winding second end is connected to positive 300 volt of the capacitor, that is bulk capacitor. When the IC is off, it don't have any chip voltage. At that time, drain pin will receive the bulk capacitor voltage through the winding here. And here is a switch, voltage regulator. It will provide charging voltage, charging current to the VDD pin. Here is VDD capacitor. When the voltage level will reach at its required threshold, at that time this switch will become open. When it will become open, at that time its UVLO interlock will start and this IC will start switching. So initial startup voltage are provided through this internal voltage regulator or charging control circuit. VDD on, VDD startup threshold. Initially when the IC is off, it will allow to charge that capacitor up to 14 volt, nominal 13 volt. When capacitor level will reach at 13 volt, we can say when the VDD pin will have 13 volt, at that time its internal UVLO circuit, under voltage lockout circuit, will turn on. That startup threshold is reached. Then this IC will start switching. If the IC starts switching and it don't receive voltage from the bias winding, from the auxiliary winding, and the capacitor voltage drop less than 8 volt, this IC will turn off. At that time it will stop switching. When it will stop switching, its internal charging circuit will turn on again. From here, this switch will turn on again. It will start charging again. When the capacitor voltage will reach again up to 14 volt, this circuit will activate again. It will start switching again. This is called reboot cycle. Ground pin is grounded to the primary ground. that is here. Positive voltage from this capacitor are reaching through this winding to drain pin, because this circuit don't have any external charging circuit or startup resistance, so it will charge from its internal voltage regulator. When it will reach up to 14 volt, this IC will disconnect its regulator and it will start switching. When it will start switching, it will allow current flow from this winding. It will generate voltage. Same time, it will receive voltage from auxiliary winding. Voltage will be rectified and it will charge this capacitor, and it will provide sufficient current for this IC for smooth operation. The internal regulator just only for charging this capacitor, and it will provide a very limited time startup. So this is the charging cycle of this IC, and this is the startup process of this IC. If this video is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.